So we'll start off with the Pledge of Allegiance, if we all could just stand. I pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. I will now hand it off to Madame Roquette for her welcome speech.
Good afternoon. I am Madame Roquette, the advisor of the Colonia High School National French Honor Society. I am delighted to welcome you to our 2023 induction ceremony. Today, we commemorate together our newest inductees, as well as members who were inducted last year, along with their devoted executive board. Each student in attendance has at least one thing in common. They have all dedicated themselves to not only the study of French language and culture, but also to the mastery of French as a vibrant and diverse language. In a world where one can simply go online and learn any language of choice, you might ask yourself, why French? Well, first of all, along with English, French is the only language spoken on all five continents. French is the international language of cooking, fashion, theater, the visual arts, dance, and architecture, all of which can be valued as both fulfilling pastimes as well as career opportunities. On the business end, French is the other language of international relations. French is both a working language and an official language of the United Nations, the European Union, UNESCO, NATO, the International Olympic Committee, the International Red Cross, and international courts. French is the language of the three cities where the European Union institutions are headquartered, which are Strasbourg, Brussels, and Luxembourg. That said, students seated here tonight are on their way to achieving a level of French that will broaden their prospects in countless areas of life, both professionally and personally. Their induction into the National French Honor Society symbolizes both their high scholastic achievement and passion for this unique and versatile language and the diversity of its culture. I am proud and excited to invite you to watch and enjoy as members and inductees come together today and perform artistic acts that reflect their passion, skill, and finesse for the French language and culture. So now I will have our president come up.
Bienvenue and welcome all to the Colonia High School's chapter of the French Honor Society's 2023 induction ceremony. Today we will be recognizing Colonia High School's valued students dedicated to embracing the French culture shown through their excellent academic performance and commitment to the Honor Society. I've been honored to represent the chapter as the president this year and celebrate the induction and recognition of our inductees and members. I have seen each and every one of the members' hard work and dedication as we all gathered for weekly meetings over this past school year. Hopefully, this early exposure to the French language and culture will prove to be beneficial in our members' futures as we all grow and become important members of the society. Now, to introduce the executive board, my name is Michelle Jonathan, and I'm the current president of the chapter and was the vice president last year. I'm a third member of the French Honor Society and have embraced the language and culture, allowing me to receive the Seal of Biliteracy in French. I hope to continue my studies in French in college, as this fall I'll be attending my school, Northeastern University, with a major in data science and business administration. I hope to one day study abroad or even work in Europe and use my French skills to communicate and connect with others there. Despite having committed to college, most people would be clocked out of anything school-related, but I stay involved with extracurriculars such as the National Honor Society, Mu Alpha Theta, Rho Kappa, FBLA, and Asian Culture Club. I will now call up our Vice President, Witha Asla.
Good afternoon, administration and fellow members, faculty, and inductees. My name is Witha Osla, and I'm the current vice president and second year member of the French Honor Society. Being a part of this honor society and taking French classes to the highest caliber has allowed me to open up to French culture. I have learned so much throughout the French language, and I will use everything I was taught through my classes and being a part of this honor society within my college career and beyond. I haven't officially committed to a school yet, but I will be majoring in clinical research with a concentration of molecular biology. I hope to one day become a cardiologist and further down the line, work with Doctors Beyond Borders and be able to use my knowledge of French in order to connect with patients and be able to understand them and create a meaningful impact in their life. I will now call up our Secretary Julia Pagnosi.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Julia Pagnosi, and I'm your current secretary of French Honor Society. I've been a French student all 4 years here at Colonia High School, and having a commitment in a program such as this has opened many doors for me. I'm also the Student Council Vice President for the Class of 2023, as well as a member of the Thespian National Honor Society, where I hold the position of publicist for the Executive Board on that Honor Society. By the end of the month, I will be committing to James Madison, where I will be continuing my studies in French. I would like to thank Madame Raquette for giving me this opportunity to study French, as it's been my main goal since I was a freshman, and I'm happy to have accomplished so much with all of you by my side. Thank you.
Give me a moment. I will be reading the honorary constitution of the French Honor Society. The general eligibility requirements to be met by all students for French Honor Society. A, membership shall be based on scholarship in general and scholarship in French in particular, leadership in French activities and interests either in a group or as an individual. B, membership shall be restricted to those students actively engaged in the study of French in a secondary school. C, candidates must be enrolled in level 3 French class. D, candidates must be in the 10th, 11th, or 12th grade of high school. Exception is made for 9th grade students who meet the requirement of C or above because of work at the middle school level. E, transfer students must have spent at least one full semester in the high school before becoming eligible. F, selection of candidates may take place at any time during the academic year. Scholastic eligibility requirements to be met by all students. A, candidates must have maintained an A- average or higher in French during the semester of selection, an average cumulative grade of A- or higher for all French work awarded secondary school credit.
Now reading the course flambeau is Michelle Jonathan. She'll be reading in French, and Witha Osla will be reading in English.
La course de flambeau est une cérémonie qui avait lieu à Athènes dans la Grèce antique. Pour cette solennité, des citoyens s'espacent formant une sorte de chaîne. Le premier allume un flambeau à l'autel, courait le transmettre à un second, qui le transmettait à un troisième et ainsi de main en main, chaque citoyen courait sans regarder entre arrière. Percevant la flamme qu'il allait remettre à un autre. Platon a reconnu dans cette course de flambeau l'image des générations de la vie. Now this is, Witha will be called up to be reading it in English.
The transmission of handing on off the torch is a ceremony which used to take place in ancient Greece. For this solemn occasion, the citizens lined up at equal distances one from the other, forming a sort of chain. The first one in line lighted the torch at the altar, ran to transmit it to a second, who transmitted it to a third, thus from hand to hand. Each citizen ran without a backward glance, keeping alive the flame which he was to hand to another. Plato recognized in this running with the torch the image of succeeding generations of life. We who shall be leaving you in a few months transmit to you the torch of our enthusiasm and our motto, Selviki se de long en vodo.
Habiba Fahmy. Sophia Fernandez. Yurisma Florentino. Kweku Mensa. Rita Nadine. Heidi Nisler. Ashna Patel. Shreya Petrevu. Gracie Singh and Maya Sutton. Tara Balog. Harmony Barber. Yesenia Cruz Blatt. Yoselyn Cruz Blatt. Jasleen Dewall. Jason Romero. Rachelle Sarang. Sierra Yanar. And now to read off the executive board name, Madame Rakit.
Congratulations, Michelle Jonathan. Witha Asma. Julia Pagnazzi.
All right, and now we will begin the candlelight ceremony. Now, if we all can just stand up and get into a circle.
All right, now as we pass the flame around, we will be reciting our French Honor Society's motto, which is Celui qui sait deux langues en vaut deux. Now, the importance of it is that it means one who knows two languages is worth two men.
And that is important as it just signifies the importance of learning French and having another culture in mind, as it really can help you and shape you into becoming a really great person. Now, I'll start us off. So oui, qui sait, de long en vaudou.
Salut, qui sait, de long en vaudou.
Salut, qui sait, de long en vaudou.
Now that we have all passed the flame around, we have all been officially inducted into the French Honor Society. So let's give us all a round of applause. Now we will begin our performances. All right, so our very first performance will be Kwai Gu Mensa, was going to be displaying a drawing called An Exploration of Tintin.
Tintin is a famous graphic novel or bande dessinée made by Belgian cartoonist Hergé. It goes through the adventures of reporter and explorer Tintin, the main protagonist, alongside his furry companion Snowy. Getting an inspiration from the comic artist, I decided to draw this piece, which is similar to a famous Tintin cover, which is often used to signify the series. The adventure of Tintin's origins would begin in Adderbeek, Brussels, where young illustrator Hergé, or Georges Prosper Remy for his real name, would get a jump start on his career by contributing his first comic strip of the Avengers of Totar to the Le Boy Scout Belge, or the Belgian Boy Scout, in 1926. While not as famous as the popular Tintin, it served as Hergé's first step into the comic book industry, as well as a precursor to what was to become for the main character. 3 years later, Hergé created the Avengers of Tintin and the conservative Catholic newspaper company Le Vingtième Siècle. The comic served as a method of conservative and anti-socialist, anti-capitalist, and anti-capitalist propaganda towards children, particularly in Tintin and the Land of the Soviets. In these comic strips, Tintin traveled to various locations, such as the U.S., Russia, and also Europe. In 1940, Le Vingtième Siècle closed, as during this time, World War II was occurring, meaning Tintin had to move to the newspaper company Le Soir, which was controlled by the Nazi administration. During this time, Tintin, who was previously envisioned as a reporter, was now an explorer as a way to avoid any potential political conflicts with the Gestapo. In 1944, due to the United Allies' interference, Le Soir was shut down, and Tintin no longer had an employer. But 2 years later, it was picked up for a final time by Le Bombard, and gave Hergé the proper working team to continue further productions. And the art style of Tintin is called Le Cycle, and basically it's more, the line work is very, it varies and it's supposed to depict cartoony people and animals, and it's supposed to contrast it with the realistic backgrounds, and it also has a more muted color palette. And that's it.
Up next, we have Maya Sutton performing a Canva presentation called Special Foods.
So my presentation is on French cuisine. The history behind French cuisine, well, the inspiration comes from medieval times where there were formal banquets held by the upper class. Since there wasn't really a way to preserve food, fresh food was always used to prepare the meals. These meals were meant to impress guests and show off wealth. In 1651, the first French cookbook was published. Not only did it inspire other chefs to publish their own cookbook, but it got many people interested in cooking. As the French colonized different parts of the world, they shared their culinary skills and techniques. So what makes it unique? French cuisine really puts emphasis on using fresh ingredients, commonly purchased from a market with local produced products. The usage of high quality ingredients differentiates French cuisine from others. The dining experience. This is connected to medieval times and the Middle Ages as well. Wealthy people would host high class gatherings. The elegant plate presentation plays a major part in the food culture. Courses are made smaller so more detail can be focused towards plating. The dining experience is refined and involves longer mealtimes, which makes it an ideal setting for socializing. Techniques used. Okay, so the first one is mise en place, which is prepping the food and having the ingredients together before starting the cooking. Next is flambéing. This is adding alcohol to a pan, and this creates a burst of flames. Sautéing, a small amount of oil in a shallow pan on high heat. Poaching, cooking food in liquid just below boiling point. Broiling, placing food on direct heat. Braising, which is just a combination of roasting and steaming, and baking. Now I'm going to talk about common meals eaten daily. French people usually eat 3 balanced meals a day. For breakfast, they'll usually have fresh pastries with jam and butter, a fruit juice, and coffee or tea, but children just have cereal. Lunch is eaten in courses. The first course is a small appetizer, something light to start a conversation. The main course is usually meat, fish, or a salad, or pasta, and the last course would be dessert. Some common lunch foods include croquet madame, which is just a sandwich with an egg on top, savory crepes, which is similar to a thin pancake, a jambon beurre sandwich, which is a quick and easy sandwich on a baguette, and omelets. Omelets are a common breakfast food in America, but common as a lunch food in France. Okay. Some common dinner choices include salmon and pepiote, which translates to salmon and parchment, and it's wrapped with veggies and all cooked together. Beef bourguignon, a beef stew braised in red wine and vegetables. This is a popular dish all over the world. Chicken confit. This dish takes its name from the French technique for preserving food by salting it and cooking it for a long time in fat. And ratatouille, a southern French vegetable stew. In conclusion, French cuisine has a long, diverse, influential history that has played a significant role in French culture. Today it is recognized for its sophistication, high quality ingredients, and global influence. It also has a strong social aspect, traditionally being a way to bring people together.
Up next, we have Tara Balog, Yerizmar Florentino, and Sierra Yanar singing Le Festin.
Thank you.
Next, we have Ashna Patel showing off a painting called The Spear.
So John Legros is a French abstract painter who was born in the year 1917. Legros has a master's in philosophy and graduated from the Institute of Psychology of Paris. John Legros began his period of minimalist abstraction in the early 1950s. His artwork showcases what he calls the energetic power of color. Legros' work has been offered at auctions multiple times with various price ranges depending on the size of the canvas. He has also written numerous essays about his theory on color, shedding light on the meaning and emotional power of each one, as well as their mutual interactions. The colors, sometimes static or sometimes dynamic, which unify or on the contrary slide and collide with each other, are brought to light, stated Legros. Legros' blue period lasted only from October 1963 to April 1964, which symbolized meditation, as the color blue equaled meditation, according to John Legros.
Next, we have Heidi Nissler performing La Vie en Rose on the trombone. Next, we have Shreya Petrevu showing off a painting called Famous French Art.
The Impressionist movement is one of the most well-known and influential art movements in history. The Impressionist movement, which took place all over Europe, had its origins in Paris, France, when in 1874 a group of artists organized an exhibition that introduced Impressionism. Some of the major Impressionist artists of the time include Claude Monet, Edgar Degas, Pierre-Auguste Renoir, and Camille Pissarro. Impressionism as a style revolves around the idea of painting impressions or how something appeared at that exact moment in time, in contrast to the paintings of mythology, history, and organized portraiture. Through the Impressionist movement, the practice of painting on plein air was created, which was the act of painting outdoors, usually very fluid and quick paintings to capture an idea or feeling. The Impressionist movement and its avant-garde nature was a major prelude to the modern art movement. The Impressionist movement, as well as the art style that came out of it, Impressionism, still influences many artists today. My personal favorite Impressionist artists are Claude Monet and Pierre-Auguste Renoir. Claude Monet was the leader of the Impressionist movement, and his art surrounded painting in open air, painting the same subjects in different lights and angles. Many of his paintings were of his own garden, but he also did paint other landscapes in his other series. Pierre-Auguste Renoir is another French Impressionist who was best well-known for his paintings that captured Parisian modernity and leisure. While he was well-known for his coloring skills, midway through his career, Renoir also started to experiment with Renaissance art, which led him to integrating more line and composition into his later works. My painting is inspired by two paintings, Bain La Grenoir and La Grenoir. The paintings were done by Claude Monet and Pierre-Auguste Renoir, respectively, and they were created during the summer of 1869, when Monet and Renoir painted together at La Grenoir, which was a popular resort a couple miles away from Paris. These mini paintings were done on plein air in preparation for larger pieces. Monet and Renoir are both incredible artists who inspire me to learn more about art and painting as well as French culture.
Up next, we have Habiba Fahmy presenting a Google Slides called French Arts and Media.
French culture and traditions. Since the 17th century, France has been regarded as a center of high culture. French culture has played a vital role in shaping world arts, cultures, and sciences. France is internationally recognized for its fashion, cuisine, art, and cinema. How much do you know about French culture? Greetings in France. Greetings are very important and must be done correctly in order to make a good impression. Handshakes are normal among acquaintances or in a business setting. Among friends and relatives, the most common greeting is la bise. French cuisine. Mealtime in France is taken very seriously, so it makes sense that they have some very specific customs around eating. Some of these rules are: don't start anything until the host has served everyone, always keep your hands on the table, always eat with both a knife and a fork, don't ask for seconds, and finish your entire plate. Fashion. Paris is often regarded as the fashion capital of the world. It is home to several worldwide brands such as Louis Vuitton and Chanel. France became a major influencer in fashion beginning the reign of Louis XIV in the 1600s. France became known for its luxury goods throughout Europe. Today, French style can be described as sophisticated and fashionable. French arts and media. The arts are deeply appreciated in French traditions. Hobbies and professions are historically shown deep respect for the craftsmanship that goes into them. French literature, painting, and cinema are all historically significant around the world. The Louvre, which is in Paris, is the largest museum in the world, housing paintings such as the Mona Lisa, which is the most famous painting in the world. French values. The French motto, liberty, equality, and fraternity, reflects the values of French honors of the French society. Equality and unity are important to the French. The French also value style and sophistication, and they take pride in the beauty and artistry of their country. Holidays. Two of the biggest holidays in France are Bastille Day, which is July 14th, and it marks the arrival of fall, and All Saints Day, which is November 1st, which is also known as All Hallows Day, or the Feast of All Saints, the Feast of All Hallows, the Solemnity of Saints, and Hallowmas. It's a Christian solemnity celebrated in honor of all the saints of the church, whether they are known or unknown. It has a lot of names, as you can tell. French customs and tips. While there are many customs the French have, here are just a few. Say hello when you enter a shop or restaurant. Always dress your best. Only smile when you really mean it. Keep your voice down while having conversations. Never haggle in stores. Don't worry about tipping servers. Leave your leftovers behind in a restaurant and arrive to dinner parties fashionably late. Thank you for watching, and I hope you learned something new about French culture.
Next, we have Rita Nadim with a painting called Recreation of Water Lilies by Claude Monet.
Claude Monet was a famous French painter who greatly influenced the Impressionism movement. Monet was born in Paris, France in 1840, but moved to Le Havre in Normandy at the age of 5. He developed his love for art very early on, filling his schoolwork with sketches. Monet moved back to Paris in 1865 to pursue his art career. Monet often worked outdoors, painting Paris's landscape and people engaging in leisure activities. Monet's impressionist work, which had rarely been seen before, transformed French art, and his unique way of capturing nature led to the modernism movement in the 20th century. He is best known for his water lily paintings depicted from his house in Giverny. After he died, the French government exhibited his water lily paintings at the Musée de l'Orangerie, a renowned gallery in Paris. Monet's work is what makes French paintings so unique and extraordinary, as he paved the way for French painters in the 19th century.
Next up, we have Harmony Barber reading a poetry called The French Language.
La douceur de ses mots fluides, the sweetness of its smooth words, lui donne en beauté infinie, gives it an infinite beauty. La musique de sa langue, the music of its language, emplit le cœur de bonheur, fills the heart with joy. La français est une œuvre d'art, French is a work of art, qui transporte en loin de la rue, that transports one away from the street. Sa poésie et sa romantique, its poetry and romance, sont un plaisir à apprendre, are a pleasure to learn. La langue française est divine, the French language is divine, et jamais je ne m'en lasserai, and I will never tire of it.
Next, we have Yaslin and Yesenia reading a quote.
I'm going to be reading a quote written by Blaise Pascal. Dans un grand ami, toi c'est grand. The quote means, in a great soul, everything is great. This poem stood out to us because it has a deeper meaning behind it. If you live a life full of positivity, good things will come in your way.
Next, we have Jasleen Dhaliwal reading a poem called Chanson d'automne by Paul Verlaine.
Chanson de l'automne by Paul Verlaine. This is another classic of French poems that every French person knows from having memorized and studied in school. The nostalgia of fall season inspired Verlaine to liken the falling rain to his tears and personify the season by mentoring the long sobs of autumn's violence as a reflection of Verlaine's own melancholy, despairing mood. The short, not quite regular lines mimic the rhythm of the rain and add to the revolving merry-go-round feeling that a woeful mood can bring. Chanson de l'automne. Les sanglots longs des violences de l'automne blessent mon cœur tout un long jour montant. Tout souffrant et les blâmes quand son l'air je me souviens des jours anciens et les pauvres et je me vois à vous ma voix qui emporte de la parler et la feel morte. The translation in English is, when a signing begins in the violins of the autumn song, my heart is drowning in the slow sound, luxurious and long, pale as with pain, breath fails me when the hours toll deep. My thoughts recover the days that are over and I weep, and I go where the wind knows, broken and brief, to and fro as the wind blows a dead leaf. Thank you.
Next, we have Sofia Fernandez doing a slides presentation on the history breakdown of Chanel and dress presentation.
Okay, bye. Michelle said, this is the beginning of Chanel. Okay, so probably most of you know at this point, Chanel was founded by Coco Chanel. She was born in rural France with five siblings, and she grew up mostly in an orphanage run by nuns. And given the very strict Catholic upbringing that she had, she wanted to implement much more free and kind of liberal forms of fashion to kind of counteract the initial upbringing that she had. She was born Gabrielle Bonheur Chanel, and she got the name Coco Chanel from the word coquette, meaning kept woman, because during her late teens, early 20s, she gained most of her money as either a seamstress by day and a singer by night. And how she got most of the money she used to open her first boutique It was using the money of several wealthy businessmen, and then she opened a boutique using their earnings. And then historical context for like when Chanel first started, World War I had just ended, and during World War I, different women were like arising as in different military ranks as either nurses or even as soldiers, and using that kind of momentum of new respect that they had gained during the war, they started to stray further and further from very restricting fashions such as corsets and using very loose forms of clothing. Coco Chanel keyed it as like the little boy look, so the garçon look, because the dresses were much more freeing. They didn't accentuate the figure. They stopped just above the ankle. And yeah, just instead of fitted corsets, they went for boxy waistlines. And it just prioritized the comfort of the woman rather than the aesthetic of it all. The first dress that kind of gave Chanel momentum as a brand was a jersey dress. Today you might hear like the phrase little black dress is like an essential that you have in your wardrobe. That comes from Chanel. The dress was so iconic because jersey used to be really only exclusively used in men's fashion. But Chanel found that it was just very easy, very breezy. And she wanted, again, to prioritize the comfort of women rather than these restrictions that were placed on them beforehand. And it just quickly became like a bestseller in the fashion house. And then the next is the tweed suit. You can probably still see this today as like a Chanel staple when you see like the collar and the fabric that's being used, like the texture of the fabric, you can probably point out that it's Chanel. Again, going back to this idea of almost like women's empowerment, suits really weren't worn by women beforehand, and Chanel kind of wanted to mix menswear and women's wear together. So using elements of the suits that were worn by men in the office while implementing some feminine elements such as the absence of the collar, a skirt instead of pants, and again, just prioritizing the comfort of women and, like I said, women's empowerment. And then comparing Chanel now, the theme of like women's empowerment and freeing women from like these constraints of fabric still persists. Karl Lagerfeld took over Coco Chanel immediately after her passing, and she worked until the day she died, and her philosophy still lived on in him. He worked until 2019, the day he died. And then after his passing, Virginie Viard took over, and she still is the creative director of Chanel now. As mentioned, like the tweed suits, definitely still implemented in Chanel's fashion today. The image at the top is one of Carl's first designs he made when he was implemented as creative director. And the image at the bottom is his last collection. It was his posthumous collection because he had already passed, but his designs had already been saved in the archives, so they were able to use them. And then to the right, Virginie. As mentioned, like the flowy fabrics of the little black dress or the jersey dress is still very implemented. It's just highlighting the comfort and not really accentuating the figure as much versus because of corsets and just, yeah, prioritizing women's comfort. And that's it. Merci.
All right. The next performance will be me with and Rachel, and we will be performing we will be presenting a slides presentation.
All right, so just like in American music, there's a wide range of French music, like classical, pop, jazz, hip hop. And here's some famous French singers. This is Edith Piaf, who wrote and sang the song La Vie en Rose.
This is Stromae, who's actually Belgian, but he sings in French. Some famous songs of his are Alors on danse, Papa Tué, and Conseil.
Claude Debussy, French composer, composed Clair de Lune, Réveillée, and La Mer.
And here is a video we made with...
Okay, so this is a video that we made just about, like, French music and, you know, all the variety of, you know, the range of music and genres.
So what we basically did was we reenacted music videos and asking people on on the streets of Paris,
yes,
what song they are listening to, and we made music videos based off of that.
Yes.
Excusez-moi, quelle musique écoutes-tu?
Les festons des ratatouilles.
Oh, merci, au revoir.
Pierre du chagrin, affaibli par la page, souris malheureux, bon lord.
Oh, excusez-moi, quelle musique écoutes-tu?
Perrault de neige.
Oh, ok, merci.
Tu ne dis pas les choses, allô, et bien, les choses de
Excuse-moi, quelle musique écoutes-tu?
Oh, ramener la coupe à la maison de Veggie Dream.
Merci! Oh, excusez-moi, quelle musique écoutes-tu?
Bella de Matthews.
Oh, merci!
Baby, veux devenir mon tati. Toi là, toi tu veux tout, sans rien dire pour moi c'est chelou. Je sais pas trop ce que t'attends de moi.
Oh, excusez-moi, quelle musique écoutes-tu?
Oh, Baby de Aya Nakamura.
Ah, merci.
Elle répondait au nom de Bella. Les gens du coin ne voulaient pas lâcher là. Elle faisait trembler tous les villages. Les gens me disaient, mais fit-toi cette fille.
Merci. And our very last performance will be Julia with her painting.
So I wrote a poem in French, but I'm also going to read it in English after I finish.
Le couvre de l'échelle à l'ancesse, monsieur Money, ce n'est pas familier. Je prie pour une promesse qui n'est pas partielle. Moi qui n'ai jamais été fidèle, je me repense maintenant. Que ce soit pas un acte de bonheur juvénile, que ce soit pas une leçon à apprendre pour moi, tu es le feu par lequel je serai consumé, là où qui pourrait me noyer. Vous serez les raisons pour lesquelles les feux se brisent comme les porcelains, mais je ne voudrais pas qu'il en soit vraiment.
And in English it means, the balance of the scale is thrown, my heart leads, this is unfamiliar. I pray for a promise that isn't partial. I who was never faithful now repent. Let this not be an act of juvenile bliss, let this not be another lesson for me to learn. You are the fire that I would be consumed by, yet the water that could drown me. You would be the reason that iron shatters like porcelain, but I would have it no other way.
Merci.
I'm going to be read one of our closing statements. On behalf of the Colonia French Honor Society, I would like to thank the administration for taking time out of your day to watch our performances and seeing the stepping stones that each of our newly members just accomplished, as well as the achievements the members have accomplished being within the Honor Society. I would also like to thank Madame Rakit for being our advisor and conducting such an organized and successful ceremony. Finally, I would also like to thank the members and the newly inducted members for the amazing performances and representing the Colonia French Honor Society with your creativity and grace.
I would like to take a second to recognize all of you. All of you should be very proud of yourselves. This isn't an easy accomplishment, you know, to go to French class every day and to make sure that you're maintaining your grades and, you know, really setting up a goal for yourself and going to meetings. So I would like to take this moment to recognize all of you. I'd like you guys to give yourself a round of applause because we don't always have people in our lives to be proud for us, but I'm proud of all of you. And I'd like to thank the executive board for being by my side during all this, and as well as the administration for coming out today and supporting all of us in our next endeavors. So thank you guys very much.
All right, so with that being our closing statements, thank you guys so much. Congratulations, and there is some food right there. Thank you.